See, today we are explaining about the development of inclined tray. So to do about development of inclined tray. See, this is an inclined tray. Okay. So if you are looking from front of an object, we are taking the dimension as 60, base is 60, and this side is 40, and this thickness is will be 20 mm, and this side is a 90, and this side is 70. See, so 60, 40, 20, 90, and 70. So top face will be 90 and 70 rectangle, and bottom face will be 40 and 60 rectangle, and thickness is 20. So if you are looking from front of an object, how it is visible? It's visible like inclined. See, if you are looking from front of an object, how it is visible? See, first is a 60 is visible, next 90 is visible, next 20 is visible. Okay, so we need to draw front view of an object first. So here I'll draw front view of an object. So first I take a reference line, means axis line. So from this axis you take, so this side is 30 and you take this side is 30. So total length is 60, because base length is 60, next top is 90. So similar way from this side you take 45. This side I'll take 45. Then I'll join these two. See, this is a front view of inclined tray. So now we'll do a development of inclined tray and we'll do the top view. So how it is visible by looking of the top view? See, if you're looking of top view, it will be visible 40 and 60 rectangle. See, so you take reference line. I take one axis. Okay, reference line. See, if you're looking from top of an object, it is visible 40 and 60. So 40 means width and 60 will be a length. So to take, see, from the midpoint, okay, so from the midpoint you take 60, right? So this side 30 and this side is 30. So take 30, so just mark it. Then from this side you take 30 and just mark it. Okay, so then, so draw projection line here, draw projection line here. Okay, so from this point you take 20, and then from this point you take 20. Okay, so this is, if you looking from top of an object, this is the rectangle, it is visible like this. So now I'll go for next step. Next is we project the line from here downward. We better do the naming here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this will be a 1 dash and 4 dash. This will be a 2 dash and 3 dash. Okay. So next this will be having, say, top face will be 90 and 70. So 90 and 70 is, so this will be already 90 is there. So better to take. So this one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 1 dash and 4, 4, 1. So here you take 2, 1 dash and 3, 1 dash. So next, from this part, you take, so it is how much? 70 means 35, 35. So take 35. So below that you take 35. So this is the top view. So this is 40 and 60, and this one is 70 and 90. Okay. So now, very simple, join. So this is 4, 1, this is 1 comma 1 and then this one is 2 1 and 3 1. So now join this and similarly here join this.
Good. So after that you need to do development, means you need to create the like this object. So how to do? So here
take one reference line from here for 60. Take one reference line here. Okay, take one reference line.
After that, you measure
distance between 1 and 1 dash. Measure it and cut an arc.
Okay,
measure it and cut an arc.
So similarly, mention the arm arc. It is going downward. Okay,
and similarly measure it and measure this and cut an arc. Cut an arc. See, show the arm arc, and you can take this as 1-4-1-, and here also 2-1-, and 3-1-.
Good. So after that,
so draw projection line downward. From here also draw projection line downward. Okay, so you join this line and similarly join this line, and here also extend this line and extend it.
Okay, see, after that join this one will be a 4-1 and this is 1-1 and this one is 2-1 and this one is 3-1. So now join 4-1-2-4 and 1-2-1 here, 2-2-1 and here 3-2-1. Okay, see, after that you need to measure the arc between 4-4-1. So measure it and you cut an arc. So which touches the projection line of 60 mm. So you just measure it and cut an arc. Okay, so measure it and cut an arc. See, show the arm arc. Next, join this. Okay, after that this stops. Measure it and cut an arc up to here. Don't draw up to this line. So 90-degree line, then join from here to here. So you can take you can show the arm arc. Show the arm arc. Similarly, you do here. So measure it and cut an arc. Show the arm arc and join this. And similarly here also measure it and cut an arc. Join this, and here also measure, cut an arc, join this. So now join so join this. Next, from here also join, here also join. So this completes your development of inclined plane. So I am drawing visible lines. So these are the part visible. So this is your development of inclined plane. Thank you.